Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sheetal Babar. In this section, we shall be discussing a very specific situation, the situation of Hindu male dying intestate. Now, what do we mean by dying intestate? Now, if you're in this situation as we're discussing a Hindu male dying intestate, means a Hindu died without making a will or without making any testimony or provisions for devolution of his property after his death. So, what happens when a Hindu male dies intestate when he has made no provisions for devolution of his property posthumously? We have certain sections under Hindu Succession Act which helps us to answer this question. Section 8 to Section 13 are the sections which gives us general as well as specific rules in certain situations related to Hindu male dying intestate. So section 8 is the general rule which in forward or which gives us four sub rules. Section 9 gives us order of succession for schedule 1. Section 10 gives us now specific rules for devolution of property amongst class 1 of schedule of Hindu Succession Act. We have in earlier session already discussed what is schedule 1 of Hindu Succession Act. So section 10 specifies specific rules for this order of succession amongst class 1 heir. Next is section 11 gives us rules for class 2 heirs or rules for devolution of property amongst class 2 heirs. Next is section 12, which gives us order of succession amongst agnates and cognates. Also, in earlier section, we have discussed who are the agnates and who are the cognates. And lastly, section 13 gives us how to calculate or how to compute the degrees of agnates and cognates. So let us go ahead with the general rule first, that is section 8 of Hindu Succession Act. What does 8 of Hindu Succession Act states is, it gives us four sub rules as I specified earlier. The first rule says, firstly, in case where a Hindu male dies intestate, the property shall be devolved upon class 1 heir of schedule 1 of Hindu Succession Act. We have in earlier session already discussed who are this class 1 of schedule 1 of Hindu Succession Act, who are these heirs. There are 16 entries in class 1 heir. And all of these, the rule to be applied for the sub-rule 1 of section 8 is all of these amongst 16 who are present or who have survived for this Hindu male dying intestate shall take the share simultaneously. So, general rule, first general rule under section 8 of Hindu Succession Act states, the property to be devolved when Hindu male who is the owner of this property dies intestate shall be devolved upon class 1 heir. Second rule states that in absence of class 1 heir, this property shall devolve on class 2 heir mentioned under schedule 1 of Hindu Succession Act. Third rule states, thirdly, if in absence of class 1 and class 2 heir, the property shall devolve on agnates. And fourth rule states, lastly, in absence of all of the above classes, the property shall lastly devolve upon the cognates. So we've already again discussed who are the cognates and agnates. Now, Section 10, 9 specifies order of succession among class 1 heir. What shall be the order specifying or rule 1 which is specified under section 8 in itself gives us an idea of the order. However, 9 specifies the order. It states as to class 1 heir first, and this shall be amongst all of them who are present in class 1 heir. So say for example in class 1 heir, the deceased son, deceased daughter, deceased widow or wife and deceased mother as well as deceased father, all of them are present. But then as per section 8 rule 1, it states as to the property shall devolve on class 1 heir. And amongst these 5 surviving people, only 4 of them who are mentioned or who are the entries in class 1 heir. Who those? Son, daughter, wife or widow, because after his death, she shall be a widow, and mother. Father is absent in class 1 heir. And hence, in this case, the property shall devolve upon 4 surviving people and not 5 of them. So, property shall be 1/4. The share of the property shall be 1/4 devolve upon the son, 1/4 devolve upon the daughter, 1/4 shall be taken up by wife, and 1/4 shall be of the mother. In case the son and daughter doesn't survive, then their sons and daughters shall take the share. However, Hindu Succession Act gives us a rule of the surviving ones. And hence we say the son and daughter of predeceased son shall take the share together. So it will be 1/4 to the son, which will be fictitious share allotted to him as if he is alive. And his share in furtherance shall be devolved upon his son and daughter, because he is actually in practice or practically isn't there into the surviving scenario. And hence, 1/8 share will be given to a predeceased son's son. 1/8 will be given to predeceased son's daughter. 1/4 share will be respectively allotted to other 3 entries of class 1 heir, that is daughter, wife or widow and mother. So this is what basically section 9 specifies as to how schedule 1 order of computation or order is to be considered. However, there are situations wherein class 1 heir are absolutely absent. So let us go ahead with the same illustration. A is Hindu male who died intestate, making no provisions of his property to be devolved in his absence. Now, who are the surviving people? Surviving people are, say for example, his father and brother. Now, these are 2 entries in class 2 heir. But class 2 heir of schedule 1 is not simultaneous devolution of property among all of the present entries, but it is the rule of priority or preferential rule is what the very essence of class 2 heir of schedule 1. That means entry 1 is preferred to all other remaining 8 entries, because there are 9 entries in class 2 heir. We've already discussed this. So, father shall be the only one in case of all of the people absent from class 1. Father will be the only one to receive the property or claim the property after death of his son, who is Hindu and has died intestate. In absence of father, then brother is the one who is surviving, shall be the receiver of the property. Provided none of them in class 2 are present who come above his entry. So there should not be any person who shall be preferred to the subsequent entries. So there are 9 entries. Entry 1 shall be preferred to all other 8 entries in class 2 heir. If one is absent, then entry 2 shall be the one which comes into this claimant frame, entry 2 shall be preferred to all other remaining 7 entries. Similarly, if 1 in 2 entry of class 2 heir is absent, then 3rd entry of class 2 heir shall be into the scenario and it shall be preferred to all other remaining 6 entries, and so on. So class 2 heir as per section 11 specifies this particular order. 12 talks about order amongst agnates and cognates. We shall be discussing this later as to how the order is to be computed, and lastly, how to compute the degrees when it comes to ascendants and descendants, or when it comes to ascendants and descendants sometimes together. So let us now see as to how section 8 is in detailed rule. 9 says what, 10, 11, 12 and 13 says what in the respective order. Now 8, as I have specified very clearly, that section 8 gives us 4 rules. First rule is, in case of male dying intestate, his property shall be devolved upon class 1 heir. Secondly, it shall be devolved upon class 2 heir. Thirdly, if in absence of class 1 and class 2 heir, rule 3 states as to, thirdly, the property shall devolve on agnates. And lastly, it shall devolve upon the cognates. Now, let us talk about this section 9, which gives us an order as to how the property shall devolve in schedule 1. So, section 9 specifically gives us the general criteria as to class 1 heir, that is rule, subrule 1, general rule specified in section 8 specifies that class 1 takes all togetherly equally amongst themselves who are present in the scenario. As in, we took an example of this. A is the male dying intestate who is survived by his son, daughter, widow and mother. All of these four people are already mentioned in class 1 heir, and hence they shall be receiving the property equally. So 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4 for all of these people, because they take the share equally. Next, it talks about class 2 heir. Class 2 heir, as I already mentioned, is preferential rule to be applied here. Entry 1 is preferred to all others. In absence of entry 1, entry 2 is preferred to all others. In absence of entry 2, entry 3 is preferred to all remaining, and so on. Section 9 also specifies, in case of absence of class 1 and class 2 heir, the order of next category comes into the scenario, and that is the agnate. The relations only with the interference of a male in relation to this male dying intestate are agnates. And hence all of the agnates shall come in, shall be preferred to those in the others. So this is basically, though section 9 very specifically does not talk about the agnates and cognates, because it specifies it later on under section 12, specifying section 9 gives us a very general rule as to class 1 heir shall be preferred to class 2. Class 1 heir takes equally those who are present all togetherly. There is no rule of preference. And class 2 shall be with application or implementation of rule of preference. So preferential rule is applied under class 2 heir. Let us see what section 10 specifies. Section 10 gives us a very specific scenario of distribution of property among heir in class 1 of the schedule. It also further gives us 4 sub-rules. Rule 1 states, if the intestate widow, or if there are more than one widows, then one share, or if there are two widows, the share shall be togetherly considered as one category by widows, and they shall be taking that one share simultaneously. So widow is one category. That is what rule 1 of section 10 specifies. Rule 2 of section 10 specifies the surviving sons, surviving daughters and the mother of intestate shall take one share each. So, first rule gives us an idea that wife or widow or widows shall take one share. So, already one share amongst the whole is to be put up for a widow to be received. So, widow can be one or can be more widows. Now, how is that possible? Maybe before commencement of this act, a man is married to two women. So, in this case, before commencement of the act, if a Hindu male is married to two women Hindus, then both of them shall take that one share, which is for the category of widow, simultaneously. There are more categories. What are those three more categories? One is son or sons shall take one share. Daughter or daughters shall take one share. And mother shall take one share. So all of these do have, we can conclude that rule 1 and rule 2 specifies that there are basic four categories under class 1H. What are those? Widow, son, daughter and mother. These are four categories, because rule 3 says the heirs in the branch of each predeceased son or each predeceased daughter of the intestate shall take between them one share. Now let us consider, we know four basic category of people who shall take the share, that is widow, son, daughter and mother are the four basic categories. In this category, let us say son didn't survive his father, whose property we are considering for devolution. But he is married and he has a son and a daughter. So in that case, it will be as per rule 3, it says that every branch of these predeceased, so it may be one son or two sons who are predeceased. In both of these situations, their legal heir, son and daughter, shall be considered togetherly as one category. So the fictitious rule is to be made applied. There are four basic categories, one-fourth, one-fourth, one-fourth to all of them, as if they all are alive. Son is absent because he didn't survive, but he has a son and a daughter. So fictitiously his share, one-fourth share, is levied upon him, and then that one-fourth share is distributed among his son and daughter. So that is what rule 3 of section 10 specifies. Next is the distribution of the share referred to in rule 3 is what rule 4 given under section 10. What does it mentions? Among the heirs in branch of the predeceased son shall be so made that his widow and surviving sons and daughters get equal portions and the branch of his predeceased son gets the same portion. That means as per rule 4, how does rule 3 applies is, in every considerate situation that there is a predeceased son or in the lineage of predeceased son of a predeceased son, the widows shall also be considered as the claimants for that one-fourth share. So, one-fourth share fictitiously levied upon that individual who is actually not surviving, his share shall be distributed in three parts. To his widow, to his son and to his daughter, or widows, sons and daughters. They shall be considered as one category when we are talking about the situation of predeceased as a criteria. So this is what section 10 specifies. Now section 11 gives us an idea as to distribution of the property amongst class 2 heir. I've already discussed this in the earlier discussion as to half class 2 heirs are preferred. Here we apply rule of preference, and hence as per section 11 of Hindu Succession Act, it is very clear that entry 1 to 9, if we are considering, entry 1 if it is surviving the Hindu male dying intestate, then entry 1 is the only person who shall receive the property, who is father. Father is entry 1. If father didn't survive his son, he is already dead or expired before his son died, then in that case entry 2 will be preferred. Preferred to all other entries and so on. So rule of preference is what section 11 specifies under Hindu Succession Act. Section 12 gives us order of succession among agnates. It has three more rules, sub-rules. What is the first rule? It talks about the very general rule about section 12 is agnates shall be preferred to cognates. So agnates are always the one who come into the scenario first and then are the cognates. So how is the rule to be applied? If there are two heirs present in the survival scenario, the one who has fewer or no degrees of ascent is preferred. So who has fewer degrees of ascent or no degrees of ascent are preferred to all others in case there are many agnates present or many agnates who are the claimants. Rule 2 says where the number of degrees of ascent is the same or none, that heir is preferred who has fewer or no degrees of descent. Thirdly, whether neither heir is entitled to be preferred to take under rule 1 or 2, they take simultaneously. So what are these degrees? First is no degree or fewer degree of ascent. Secondly, no degree or fewer degree of descent. And thirdly, if both of the ascents and descents degrees related to the intestate and that individual who is there in the survival screen, then both of them shall take the share simultaneously. For which we can take a support of section 13 of Hindu Succession Act, which states how these computation of degrees happen. How do we talk about this degree of ascent and degree of descent and fewer and more degrees of ascent and descent? It gives us three rules. Simplifyingly, the first rule is for the purpose of determining the order of succession among agnates and cognates, relationship shall be reckoned from the intestate to the heir in terms of degrees of ascent. So, inclusive of the intestate. So, the one who dies is in the degree of ascent or fewer degrees of ascent. The agnate. So, say for example, who shall be in fewer degrees of ascent? We take an example of A dying in, A is a Hindu male dying intestate. No class 1 and class 2 heir are present. So, brothers, A's brother's wife has lesser degree of ascent and hence she shall be preferred. So, this is how the close of the relation is what section 13 tells us how to compute the degrees. The fewer degrees in relation to the intestate is the simple criteria given under section 13. We always under section 13, very specifically apply this rule that relations shall be inclusive of the intestate. So, degree of intestate or generation of intestate and the degrees of descent or degrees of ascent shall be calculated. The more the nearer, the more the winner of the claimant for receiving the property. So, this is how basically the provisions or legal provisions of Hindu male dying without making any testimony or without making a will of half his property to be devolved after his death. In this situation, we make section 8 to section 13 of Hindu Succession Act read with each other. We make it applicable to simplify that who shall be the claimant of his property. So, this is all from my side when it comes to provisions of male Hindu dying intestate. Thank you so much.